On the 24th of June, 2022, these videos appeared on social media. They were coming out of this patch of land in Morocco. At least 23 African migrants died here. They clashed with Moroccan security forces as they tried to storm the border and cross illegally into European territory. During the crackdown, the migrants were driven into a corner. Some were crushed to death. Others were thrown to the ground and beaten. This was the deadliest day on record at the border between Morocco and Spain. And months later, nobody has been held accountable for what went wrong. BBC Africa Eye has verified dozens of these videos. Some were posted online, others were given to us privately. We interviewed migrants who survived.
If you move, they will hate you. If you say something, they will hate you. Even you didn't say, even they hate you.
To find out how this deadly day unfolded and ask, why was such violence used? Why does it look like there was no medical intervention? And why is there still no information about the 24 people who died and the many more unaccounted for? Melilla and Ceuta are two tiny Spanish enclaves on Morocco's north coast. They are Europe's only land borders on the African continent and key destinations for African migrants hoping to make their way into Europe. The border fence around Melilla has been a regular target for decades. This is a BBC report from 2014.
The tallest of the three fences is 8 meters high. But the migrants have developed tactics and techniques which have proved very effective.
In recent weeks, hundreds at a time have scaled the fence, filmed by the police, who call it a human avalanche.
On the 24th of June, 2022, an estimated 2,000 migrants descended on the Moroccan-Spanish border post called Barrio Chino. We've already seen what happened next. But these videos alone don't give us the full picture. Africa Eye tracked down several migrants who were there that day. These men, all from Sudan, have traveled more than 2,000 kilometers for months, some even years, via dangerous migration routes through Libya and Algeria to reach Morocco, hoping to make it to Europe, where they want to claim asylum. They've come from the war-torn region of Darfur. For security reasons, we've protected the identity of those still in Morocco. But one of them, Yusuf Aboubaida, has since made it to Spain. The enclave of Melilla is surrounded by hilly forests where migrants often set up camp before attempting to cross the border. It has become the backdrop to a cat-and-mouse game between migrants and Moroccan security forces. These videos show clashes started on the 23rd of June, the day before the migrants stormed the border fence.
قبل ما احنا نوصل او نتحرك تم مداهمتنا في الجبل ده زي ما انتم شايفين الفيديوهات ظهرت فهم طلعوا لنا فوق وان احنا حاولنا انسحبنا رجعنا لورا كان هدفنا انه نتراجع لحد ما نكون قريب للجبل
وفي نفس الليلة بعثوا لنا ناس قالوا لنا خلال 24 ساعة لم نتفرغ من الجبل قال إنه جاء تصريحات من السلطات العليا إنه استخدموا معنا الرصاصة الحية وبعد ذلك في نفس الليلة نحن اتحركنا عشان على سياج
The earliest video from the morning of the 24th shows the migrants taking this route towards the border. They could be seen coming from a distance.
If they want to stop us, they will stop us before we come in the wall. Why?
Early in the morning, the crowd is seen marching towards the border via this road. There appears to be no attempt by authorities to stop the group reaching the border post of Barrio Chino, which is now only a few hundred meters away. In this video, we see how police vans drive away as the crowd approaches in the distance. Bystanders filmed the migrants as they came through this street. Past the roundabout, towards the border fence. Moroccan authorities said they were armed with sticks, stones, and sharp objects.
If we have a stick, that is stick to help me climb the wall. This is just all we have. This is not a step to hit another person, something like that.
As the front of the group reaches the fence, they try to force open this gate. We can see the security forces moving in from behind. And the migrants get split into smaller groups. Some made it through the first fence, while the others were targeted with tear gas and smoke bombs.
دي طبعا من آثار إن لو واجهتك في جسمك بتشرد بطنك تفتح بطنك مثلا أو يدك أو كراك أي جهة بتشرد اللحم وبتكسر العظام تخدم السلاح ده آخر طريق للناس إن الناس بدت يعني خشت فينا الرعب والفزع يعني الصدمة بقت كبير.
The migrants gradually moved through this street, trying to climb the fence at different points. Notice this corner. That's this blue fence here. And behind it is a small enclosed courtyard with a covered area in the middle. We can also see a Moroccan flag on this corner and a white van parked in the distance. They will help us place some of the other videos. At another point in this video, we see a woman being kicked from behind by one of the Moroccan security forces. A video from this side of the road. There, we see the same white van, shows how migrants are being approached by Moroccan security forces from both sides of the street. The migrants say security forces blocked their path out and continued to fire tear gas and smoke bombs towards them.
في راسك انا كنت في الجانب الجوا كنت داخل السياج والوراي طوالي وقع بهم السياج للعدد لانه في خمي مفرد من العساكر.
It's unclear how long the chaotic confrontation lasts. Many make it across the first few fences but then become stuck in enclosed areas of the border infrastructure, mainly the courtyard we saw earlier.
الحصل في المنطقة الضيقة اللي هو مساحة 100 متر تقريبا منطقة يعني شكل بيت كده لما دخلنا هناك اتفاجأنا انه ما في مخرج.
A large number of Moroccan security forces gathered outside the courtyard in front of the blue fence, preventing anyone from retreating. They can be seen throwing tear gas and smoke bombs into the enclosed spaces. This panorama gives us a clear view of the courtyard, which has now become the focus of the violence. This video, filmed from the Spanish side of the border, shows the extent of tear gas and smoke bombs used.
من كل الاتجاهات والحكومة بدأت تضغط علينا. عرفت إننا محاصرين ما في مخرج لنا. كان بإمكان الحكومة إنها تجي تعتقلنا. إحنا استسلمنا رافعين الأيادي ما عندنا حاجة غير أيادينا دي. لا صلاح ولا شيء يعني. كان بإمكانها تجي تعتقلنا. تطلعنا من الباب وترجعنا للأماكن بتاعتنا. لكن حصلت العكس. فهم من كانوا استخدم فينا كل السلاح اللي كانوا مدججين به.
At some point, the courtyard became so crowded, people panicked, and there was a stampede.
يعني أنا رجلي ده قاعدين فيه ناس قريب من 50 نفر ولا 40 نفر. لا قادر توديها يمين لا شمال. لحظة عصيبة الحمد لله.
والمضافر والحاجات حتى أنا من ضمن الناس من ضمن المضافر ده لكن وقعت بتحت وكانوا في ناس بيفوق لي وكده. في ناس الحقيقة إنها ماتت فقدت أرواح بسبب المضافر ده جزء بسيط. لكن السبب شنو؟ إنه في بإمكان الأسكري أو الزول اللي قاعد يضربك بالسلاح ده بإمكانه كان ينغزك بفتحة باب فهمتني؟ أو يخد سلاحه ده ويجرك لأنك أنت ما ارتكبت جريمة.
While most migrants were trapped in the courtyard, others did make it across the border into Spanish territory, but the majority were held back by Spanish security forces. Spanish journalist Javier Bernardo was filming on the Spanish side of the border. His footage shows Moroccan security forces entering Spanish territory to take migrants back to Morocco without giving them the opportunity to claim asylum. This practice is often referred to as pushbacks, and the legality of it is contested.
This maybe you can see the 300 people, maybe.
How many pushbacks did you see that day?
300 people.
300?
Yeah, everything, everyone here.
Yusuf was one of them.
And then in Spain, they come, and then they tied my hands. I'm good, so I'm not injured. So when they take me, they are Spanish, they give me police, Moroccan police. Moroccan police, they, some of them, they kick me. Some of them, they hit me. The ones have a very strong stick that began to hit me in my head. And when they hit me, that I fall down. So I didn't move again.
Yusuf is taken back to the same location where the migrants were being detained on the ground. He told us he was restrained and beaten so badly, he lost consciousness for several hours. He was lying here.
وفي النهاية العسكر سيطر علينا ومسكونا يعني بعد ما مسكونا هو كلنا ردمونا في حتة واحدة كلنا فوق بعض يعني بعد ذاك كانوا بيستخدموا معنا ضرب بليغ جدا يعني حتى الضرب كان الغرض منه الضرر بالروق يعني لتاريخ اليوم أنا عندي هسه ما يقارب الشهر ونصف ولا شهرين إلا عندي شلل نصفي في قراية يعني حتى الآن عندنا اخواننا عندي ثلاثة من الناس في نفس اللحظة كانوا يدفوا جنبي يعني الحادثة.
Videos show migrants detained in the courtyard and in the area in front of the blue fence. In some of the videos, too graphic to show, we can see lifeless bodies being tossed around, people bleeding and in agony, seemingly being offered no assistance.
بعدك والجهلينا إحنا ما متنا والجهلين استفزازات مباشرة إنه إحنا العملنا فيكم ده بس حاجة أنتوا بتستهبوا أكتر من كده أنتوا ما بشر ما يعني إحنا ما شايفينكم حاجة أنتوا ما بتسووا شيء يعني فبدوا بيخونا برجلين بيعصرونا بالبود في وشك كده بيضحكوك في وشك كده و بيضربوك لو اتاكدوا انك انت ميت بيمشوا بخلوك لو ما ميت بيحاولوا بيضربوك للمره الثانيه انه لازم يسوبوك في يخلوا فيك اثر.
والله اللحظه دي اسمك لحظه عصيبه جدا اساسا انه انت بتشوف اخوك هو قدامك بيموت ولا بقتله فيه وانت ما تقدر تعمل فيه حاجه لحظه عصيبه جدا جدا يعني.
The migrants told us they were kept on the ground with injured and dead people among them for several hours without any medical care.
الإسعاف اتأخر ممكن كان يسعفوا الناس اللي ما ماتت لسه لكن للأسف هم وقفوا الإسعاف حتى ما يجي يشيل الجرحى.
Later that evening, buses collected the migrants, many of them severely injured, and took them to cities across Morocco.
Some people in the bus, they need help very very fast. They need help, but no one help.
عندنا واحد في الباص كان هو برضه يتوفى في نفس الباص. يعني بعد ما عطونا الأكل وكده عشان هو عطوا أكل عشان هو يأكل. مش يتكلم عليهم. مرة مرتين ما رد له. بعد ذلك جل واحد سأله وقلنا له زول ده ميت. ميت قال ميت قلنا له زول ده ميت. يعني مشينا مش أعرف في محل اسمه سلوان ولا.
The name of the man who died on the bus was Abdel Nasser. One of the migrants managed to take a picture of his body before he was removed from the bus. They sent it to his brother back in Sudan to inform him of his death.
حاجه انا ما وريته اسو كلام ده بعد ما بتفهم اسو معني هان كده ما بسمع منه ولا سامع منه ولا حاجه زاده.
It is unclear what happened to the bodies of any of the victims. But several independent sources have told us there are currently dozens of bodies being held in the morgue in Nador, the Moroccan city closest to Melilla. Africa Eye tried to investigate these claims, but was denied access to the area by Moroccan authorities. The Moroccan Association for Human Rights says more than 70 people are still missing.
من السلطات كانت تريد دفن الجثث، كانت تريد دفن الجثث دون القيام يعني بالتحقيقات اللازمة ودون أن تتعرف على الجثث. يعني ونحن ضبطنا السلطات يعني في مقبرة الناظر وهي تحفر يعني 21 قبرا داخل 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 المقبرة وعندما فضحناهم يعني توقفوا عن استكمال العملية.
The Moroccan government declined our request for an interview, but the Director of Migration and Border Surveillance in Morocco's Interior Ministry, Khalid Zerouali, did speak to Spanish media, defending the actions of Moroccan officers.
Les services de l'ordre ont agi selon la doctrine qui est une doctrine de maintien de l'ordre, quoique les gens qui étaient devant eux, c'était des gens aguerris, avec une formation militaire, avec des gens qui ont fait de la guerre, avec des gens qui ont participé, qui ont évolué dans des zones de des foyers de tension. Et donc, c'est des gens qui n'étaient pas des migrants, je dirais, comme ceux qu'on a l'habitude de voir.
Both Morocco and Spain are facing questions about what happened on June the 24th. In a tweet, Spanish MP John Inarritu points to records of the Spanish National Geographic Institute and the National Land Registry, which he says prove that the events of June 24th happened in Spanish territory. And in September, he questioned the Spanish Minister for Interior on this issue in Parliament.
Eso que usted ha dicho de que donde ocurrieron los hechos más graves es una tierra de nadie, parece el título de una película, de un western, no más land no existe en derecho internacional. Es territorio español. Aclárelo hoy aquí. Mire, la tragedia fue en Melilla, o al menos entre Melilla y Nador. La actuación policial fue conjunta. Ustedes, el gobierno ha reconocido esa coordinación.
It's difficult to pinpoint exactly where the deaths occurred. We're going to focus on two areas, this enclosed courtyard and the entrance section leading into it. Our team was given access by Spanish authorities to the Barrio Chino border post in August. We filmed the enclosed courtyard through the fence, looking in from the entrance section. We can see the covered area and the Moroccan flag on the corner. We were told the territory on this side of the courtyard, the entrance section with the blue turnstiles, is Spanish controlled. Now, if we go back to the videos, most of them show lifeless and injured migrants here in the enclosed courtyard referred to by authorities as no man's land. But in this video, we can see the gate between the two areas has been pushed open, and there's a crush of bodies spilling out of the enclosed courtyard into the entrance section, with three lifeless bodies slumped against the blue gate. In another video, too graphic to show in full, we see what looks like the aftermath of that crush in the entrance section. Notice the same blue turnstiles in the background. In this video, there is at least one dead body on the ground in the entrance section and other lifeless bodies being moved back from there by Moroccan security forces. This is the area we were told by Spanish authorities is under their control. Spain's Minister of Interior, Fernando Grande Malasca, had a different take.
Por tanto, lo primero que tenemos que dejar claro es que los hechos suceden en territorio nacional de un país soberano y de manera muy tangencial tiene lugar en España.
Both Spanish and Moroccan authorities have begun internal investigations into what happened on June the 24th. But to date, neither have released any CCTV footage or taken any responsibility for the high death toll and the apparent lack of medical care.
منطقة ميليليا عندها كاميرات للمراقبة تقريبا في كل السياج وفي المنطقة اللي اتحاصرنا فيه والناس ماتت برضو فيها الكاميرات بتاعت المراقبة طالب الدولة إنها تبرز ما لديها من أدلة لتبرر ذلك مثلا للجميع.
There seems to be a significant difference in how Moroccan security forces responded to migrants on this occasion compared to previous attempts in recent years. This is a BBC report from May 2021.
When the first of 8,000 people simply walked or waded round the border post at low tide, Moroccan officials seemingly did nothing to stop them. Morocco stands accused of allowing this unprecedented influx. Last month, it warned Spain of consequences amid a diplomatic row. It seems this is what they were talking about.
At the end of 2021, the diplomatic relationship between Spain and Morocco broke down on the issue of migration, with Morocco arguing it needed more financial support to defend the border. Then, in April of 2022, the two countries signed a new agreement on border control. Human rights groups say Morocco's response to migrants hardened again as a result of this agreement.
زوج مارس 3 مارس و 8 مارس يعني شارك فيها حوالي 2500 مهاجر كانت اكبر ونزلوا من الغابه بعيدون مشكل ولم يقع لا موت ولا الفرق الوحيد هو ما بين مارس ويونيو هو ان العلاقات في مارس الاسبانيه المغربيه يعني كانت مقطوعه وكانت في ازمه وفي يونيو يعني رجعت العلاقه وفي 24 يونيو يجوا به بكل ذلك العنف وذاك الغازات المسيله للدموع.
2 weeks after June the 24th, the EU signed a new partnership agreement with Morocco on migration control, and in August agreed to pay Morocco 500 million euro to cover the next 5 years. We put the allegations made in this film to the Spanish government. This is how they responded.
133 people entered Spanish territory. Their asylum claims are being processed. Any rejections at the border were made according to Spanish law, endorsed by the European Court of Human Rights. The claim that 300 migrants were forced back to Morocco from Spanish territory is absolutely false. No dead bodies were moved from Spain to Morocco. All CCTV recordings have been handed over to the Spanish judiciary and ombudsman as part of their investigations.
We also contacted the Moroccan government, but they did not address the allegations made in this film. In August, Yusuf made it across to Spain by boat. 18 people died doing that same journey that week. He is now in the process of applying for asylum in Spain. But his friends in Morocco are still living on the streets and struggling to process the events at Barrio Chino. 75 migrants who were there that day have been prosecuted by Moroccan authorities. They're facing up to 2.5 years in prison.
أسأل السؤال ده للعالم أجمع ليه الإنسان رخيص للدرجة ده فزنبه شنو إنه بعد يموت بعد يشبع الموت ويموت في دولة في 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 طريق الحجرة أو في دولة زي المغرب أو قريبة للاتحاد قريبة لإسبانيا بينات مع أمتار مثلا كاننا ننخرج في الميليشيات مثلا في بلدنا لأنه ده الطريقة الوحيدة تقدر تعيش تقتل عشان ما يقتلوك نختار الطريق الأسوأ عشان نغير الحياة ده قدرنا طلعنا من كل بقع الموت بورك صدمة ما ممكن تتخيله فأنا ما مت اليوم وديك لكن اتمنيت إنه أكون ما موجود في الحياة تاني اتمنيت إنه أنا لو لحقتهم كان أكون أسعد يعني